It's on every day.
Wow. Yeah,
you would think it was on all. You would think it, but the Munsters was on for 10 years, wouldn't you?
Well, they will. Yeah, amazing.
I think it's always fun for our listeners to know how you got on the show. How did it work out for you?
As a matter of fact, I came and tested right here at CBS Studio Center, and I was living in Illinois, and they'd gone through a lot of kids, and I came out, and I had fangs that stuck straight out of my teeth, and they go, hey, we don't have to buy the kid fangs, let's hire him, you know?
And for me, they had been testing girls. There was another girl that had started the show in the beginning and was leaving to go back to New York, and they were testing girls. They'd been testing them for about 3 months, and this was the last day, and they tested five of us. And this was on a Wednesday. They called me in to tell me that I had the job on a Friday, and I started work on Monday.
Whoa. That's the way it happens, though.
Sometimes.
It really does.
Wacky business.
How about the makeup? Now, you mentioned
the fangs. Oh, yeah, my ears and my widow's peak, and everybody thinks that Mr. Spock had pointed ears first. Well, I'll set the record straight. It was Eddie Munster ears.
You bet it was.
No, the makeup was hard, and it was. We went to a lot of trouble with that, but the special effects and the makeup made for a little bit harder than normal, but I enjoyed it myself. I was a kid. I had a lot of energy, but it was tough on Fred and Al because of the heavy suit and the heat and everything.
Yeah, right.
I didn't have any of those problems. I was the normal one.
Yeah,
that's right.
She was the homely one, you know, poor cousin Marilyn.
Yeah, no pointed ears, no fangs, nothing. Did you have any idea how big the show would be or successful?
Oh, no, if I had known at the time, I would have saved every script, every piece of memorabilia, and that would be my retirement fund today.
Yeah, you're right. Of course, big, big collectibles now, right?
Very much so.
Just make them up.
Yeah, right.
I wish I could.
Say that. This is what I wore. What have you guys been doing since the Munsters?
Well, I've acted till I was about 21, and then I kind of phased out of the business. And as of late, I've been doing a lot of personal appearances. I've represented a company called Cut Ups, and they manufacture things like this. And I brought some along from Pat. I've seen that.
That's
really a neat thing. Great. And we do this. And I also I'm working on a comedy act, stand-up comedy.
Is that right?
Yeah. Kind of a funny guy.
You're gonna go back in costume?
No. Once is enough for anybody. Walking around with short pants and a doll is just not my style, you know? No wonder I'm weird.
I don't know. Our producer, Richard Klein, does it all the time. Producer, what about you?
Well, after the show, I went on to do a lot of television shows and commercials. And now I'm living in Sun Valley, Idaho, and I'm restoring Victorian homes.
Ooh, that's the place to do it. Beautiful. That's wonderful. Well, listen, thank you for being with us, and good luck to you.
It's fun
to see you. Okay. A little visit down memory lane with the Munsters. And now I would like you to meet our next guest. Would you please welcome Marnesba and Magdalene?